Thank you for joining me. So today we're going to be going through how to do batch payments in Xero. Very quickly, what are batch payments? So as you can see here, they are a group of payments that show up as a single debit on your bank statement. So this means that all those bills that you have in Xero, so all of your supplier payments that need to be paid, you can actually go through and tick which ones you need to pay, download an ABA file and upload that straight to your online banking. So this will pay all your suppliers in one go, but only show one single transaction on your bank statement. So not only does it save you time, it actually removes room for error as well. So there's, you know, no more typos or accidentally paying that GST exclusive amount on that invoice. I'm going to go through a demo of how to do this in Xero. So as you can see here, we're in our demo file and we're going to navigate over to our bills. So under business tab, go to the awaiting payment tab. So this is going to show all your bills are waiting to be paid. Now under the plan date, a bit of a tip, you can actually schedule your payments. So say you want to pay invoices before they become due, you can actually put the date in. This just keeps you on track of what's to be paid and when, and you can do it in bulk if you have a lot of bills, like I just did here. So we have actually been quite naughty. As you can see, there's a number of invoices overdue past the due date. So we're going to pay all these today. So I'm going to select the ones that I want and create a batch payment. So Xero's recently updated their batch payment screen. So it's actually nice and new and makes it a lot more user-friendly. So you can see here it's been navigating now. We're going to select which bank account we want to pay it from. So from our main business bank. If you were with NAB, there would be an option to go through to online banking, but we're going to continue. So all these grey cells have come straight from the bill, so these can't be edited, but anything in a white cell can be. So if you look at the payment date, you can actually use the drop down and select which date to pay, so today or in future. We can also edit the bank account. So if it was a new bill, we can enter in their BSBN account number directly from this screen, and also update any change of bank account details for another supplier. This will also update their contact details in Xero, so any future batch payments you do make will also have their new updated bank account details. We can also update the payee reference. So this usually populates straight from the reference in the bill, but usually, you know, suppliers ask for their invoice number. If it doesn't pre-fill, you can edit it here. You can also change the payment. So say you don't want to pay the invoice in full, it might be a part payment or a deposit, you can change it here. And if you've made a mistake, you can remove a bill from that batch payment too. Have a quick review, make sure it's all correct. Once you're satisfied, we are going to continue to payment summary. So you can see at the top, it says your batch payment has been created. So we're just going to finish that and click this button here. So from here, you've got an option on the drop-down to edit it. So if you've made a mistake or need to update details, you can, or start again by clicking remove and redo. If you're satisfied, click that export batch file option. You shouldn't receive any errors, but if you did like me, this is because I have dummy bank details in there, you can go back and edit them and recreate that batch file. Or if you've successfully downloaded that, you can, it should be in your downloads, an ABA file, log into your online banking, go to your new bills and upload your file there, depending on what bank you're with. So that's how you to do batch payments in Xero. If you do have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. We've got our contact details on the screen here for you. So you can contact us via our phone there on the screen or through that email address. And please don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. This makes sure you stay up to date with all our content. And we do have a lot of great content out there. So I do advise to check that out. Thank you.